it's a bit like, I feel a bit like the caveman who dropped in the middle of New York. Because Argentina comes from a decade in which we have fallen behind in structural transformation, in global integration, and this is, on the one hand, a bad thing, because over the past 4 years, the economy hasn't been growing, we haven't seen investment, we haven't seen job creation in the private sector. But at the same time, coming here, it's an opportunity, because we get to learn from our colleagues from all over the world. And I have to say, it's the new structure of the Argentine government is in part a tribute to Ricardo's intellectual influence.
All right. So, as I was saying, caveman, right? No microphone, no technology. Basically, we have changed the structure of the governance of the economy. We have a finance ministry that does public finance and debt. And then we have a production ministry that does pretty much everything else, the micro stuff. And it has a secretary there that's called the Secretary of Productive Transformation. We were going to call it Ricardo Hausmann Secretary, but we thought it was a bit too much. This is Lucio Castro. His job is actually to work on understanding the monkeys, the trees, and what they're going to do in order to make the Argentine economy more diverse, more competitive, more productive. We're embarking on a challenging reform program, and this program starts with the basics. We have a political and economic normalization, and this is a very important lesson. I mean, it's good to remind ourselves that having a well-functioning polity and having basic macroeconomic stabilization and a well-functioning macro is a necessary prerequisite for the stuff that we're talking about. So we're learning about that. In the first 4 months, we've eliminated exchange rate controls. We've reopened the economy to international trade. We've lowered export taxes. And this week, we're on the verge of finally solving the holdout situation, which basically had avoided the possibility for Argentina to borrow money in the international financial markets. Macro stability is a necessary condition. It's very hard to plan productive transformation if you don't know what the inflation rate is, if you don't know what the exchange rate, how the exchange rate is going to move around. But also what Ricardo and another of his colleagues called appropriability of returns is key. You have to be able to know that if you invest, you're going to be able to get that money back. And if your political environment is one in which you might be strategically, expropriated in different through different techniques, then clearly investment is not going to be there. And that is a fundamental issue. And that, for now, is going well. But now that we've basically, I would say, set the framework for a stable macro, a reasonable polity, the hard part begins. In the immortal words of Carlos Tevez, a well-known Argentine football player, when he left Manchester, "It's very difficult," he said. "No? It's very difficult, very difficult." Now we have to work. And I have to mention, now I see Eduardo Levi-Jejati there. Eduardo is heading a strategic planning group in the government that is working on thinking about these long-term issues and bringing together people from different areas of the government. But I would say, to be concise, I mean, a key issue is getting investment in the competitive sectors, generating new competitive sectors, and managing the political transition and the political fallout from moving factors from less competitive to more competitive sectors. We're launching an ambitious infrastructure plan. This is, again, a necessary condition to reduce costs across the economy. This plan calls for a $50 billion investment over the next 4 years. We're working on trade facilitation and new trade deals. Once again, here we're 10, 15 years behind Chile, Mexico, and it's something we have to put a lot of emphasis on. We've already generated new trade deals with the US, we're starting to work with Japan. In fact, we're working with Mexico. I have a call from Mr. Rosenzweig yesterday, so he wants to move forward. That's a good thing. This is once again part of the sort of the necessary environment that we need to move forward in productive transformation. Another key area in the production ministry is everything that has to do with innovation and entrepreneurship. We have a specific secretary that works on small and medium enterprises and entrepreneurship, and they're going to be investing in accelerators in order to increase the rate of creation and the growth of entrepreneurs. We're working on revamping competition policy. Once again, Chile here has done a lot of work. Mexico has done a lot of work. We basically found that the competition agency was destroyed. There was no people that could actually do competition work in the government. It's a highly technical challenge. You need high quality economists, lawyers, etc. So we're setting that up, and it's a key issue not only to make sectors competitive, but it's key for the legitimacy of the system. If small enterprises and consumers feel that large companies have an unfair advantage, then the general legitimacy of the reform process is undermined. So we see this as key not only for the essence itself, for the competition that it generates, but also for the political legitimacy it provides to the process. So I hope in the next conference that we have to bring beautiful charts of everything we're doing. But up to now, we're setting up shop. Argentina has fantastic natural resources, of course. We have 2.4% of the world biocapacity. We're producing food for more or less 400 million people, and this can double over the next 10 years. We have great resources in the energy sector. Vaca Muerta, which is this formation in the province of Neuquén, is the second largest deposit of shale gas in the world and the fourth largest shale oil deposit in the world. The prices aren't there now, but they will be eventually, and if not, technology will catch up. We have huge potential in the solar and wind sectors. In fact, I was talking to an engineer at GE. He said that the winds in Patagonia can produce enough electricity to cover the whole continent. Of course, the problem is these winds come in huge gusts and they break the turbines. So we need somebody to invent a good turbine that can survive those winds. But basically, we need to work hard on a clear strategy on moving forward in these ideas of productive transformation, and that is what we're going to be doing over the next year. And as I said, we expect to be here next time with the achievements of this process. Eduardo, I'm sure, will be here telling you all about that. So thank you very much.